Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Biola, Party Heaven. So this is our last video for this season of Create With Me. We've got restrictions in the UK, so we can't really go set up like we used to. So I'm not sure, another one might come up after this, but for now, this is going to be the last episode. I hope you guys enjoy it. So today's video is me creating a garland that I extended to the ceiling. So I'm using pinks, yellows, and lilacs, and I've double stuffed the balloons. The pink ones I double stuffed into white and pearl white. The yellow I double stuffed into pearl ivory balloon, and then the lilac I double stuffed into pearl white. Then I used a bit of rose pink. So I'm arranging the balloons onto a fishing line first before I then hang it to where I'm going to be placing it. I love to do setups like this because the client has given me like a free rein to do what I want. So I was just able to create something beautiful. And the theme was butterflies. So it was so easy and fun to do. So here I'm just doing my clusters and then arranging it onto a fishing line. So I'm using a set of 16 inches and a set of 11 and 12 inches on the size. So if you're thinking about sizing again, please watch my tutorials on proper balloon garland sizing. I try to brief you on it. Organics do not have a set size. All you need to do is undersize your balloon. So if you're using an 11 inches, just undersize it and make sure the two balloons are two different sizes, and make sure the next one you inflate are not of the same size of the first ones you inflated. So just make sure you're having, balloons of varying sizes. So what I'm just doing is I am, trying to give a shape to the main garland already. So I am using the 16 inches with the 11 inches. And then when I get to a point, I use just the 11 inches balloon so that the balloons will have that organic look. It's not going to look like straight. So just keep arranging this and stacking it onto the fishing line. So initially I tied this, the fishing line to the doorknob. You can see right behind me, but I didn't tie it well enough, so it fell off. But this didn't hinder me to continue, stacking on the balloons. I was still able to stack all the balloons onto the fishing line. So you would notice that I pack my balloon tightly. I do not let it flop around. It's always so tight. So now I am going to use my hooks. To buy these hooks, you would find them in my Amazon store. The link is going to be in the description. So these hooks are so good. Like, compared to command hooks, they are like the best I have ever found. You just need to buy the really good ones. And these ones I'm using, you would find in my Amazon store. Link below. Just click on the link and then you can purchase yours. So I was able to like put in strategic places so that I would be able to hang my garland onto it and start, you know, finishing off my arrangement. So here I'm just standing and thinking of where to place it, because it's not like I have, you know, I don't have it in my head the way I want the garland to turn out. But as I go on, I tend to like decide on what I want the garland to look like at the end of the day. So once I've put it on, I just tie on my 260 Q. And when I tie the 260Q on, I tie it at the very end so that I can, you know, extend it out and wrap it into the garland. This makes it easier for me to add more balloons. So once you've done that, just, you know, just wrap your 260Q attached to the hooks to your main garland. Now that my garland is in position, the next thing is I start from the bottom. I prefer to like start adding the balloons from the bottom. There are times I do it from the top, but for this one, I started from the bottom because of the height of where I've tied the upper part. So it's easier for me to like, you know, see what I'm doing and walk my way from bottom to the top. So I wanted this garland to have like a curvy kind of look. I didn't want it to just be a straight one. So you can see me moving the balloons around and, you know, trying to like shape it. So the garland has got like a zigzag kind of, you know, you wouldn't be able to see that well enough in the video because of the angle of my camera, but it had this kind of zigzag kind of look. So a lot of you, I know you talk about the bottom part and all of that. How do you get that bottom part to be bulky and all of that? I tend to like use the bigger balloons to fill it out first, and then I add the smaller balloons at the end. This makes it easier for me. So you can see the balloons I'm attaching are more of like 16 inches and the 3-footer. And they are mini garlands. So guys, see me vibing here. That is me when I'm on the job and there's music on and I'm happy about what I'm doing. I dance while creating. That's another thing I love to do. I love to dance. So you see me dancing. This is just a one-off one where I decided to like share this part of me with you guys. So yeah, you just keep adding your mini clusters to the main garland, color by color, and just being creative about it. So I added the butterflies on, and there you go. And I then added a bit of chrome balloons. I think I used a mix of rose gold and I've forgotten the second chrome I used now, guys. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed this create with me video. Please remember to subscribe, share, and like. See you some other time. Bye.